Hello friends, welcome to Unity Scripting API Mono Behavior series. From the past few video tutorials, we are trying to understand predetermined execution order of mono behavior event methods. In the previous video tutorials, we discussed awake event method, on enable event method, on application pause event method, on application focus event method, start event method, fixed update event method, and update event method. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss late update event method. Remember that when we run the game application, first scene of the game is loaded. When scene is loaded, all objects of the scene are created and initialized. After all objects are created and initialized, awake method is called first on all objects. Immediately on enable event method is called. That is, immediately script is enabled. After all objects are created and initialized, after all attached scripts are enabled, game application comes to foreground. When game application comes to foreground, on application pause event method is called. After that, immediately on application focus event method is called. That is, immediately game application gets focus. Once game application gets focus, first frame of the scene is created. On the first frame, start method is called. After first frame of the scene is created, it is going to be continuously updated and rendered. That is, continuously updation and render methods are called. In the previous video tutorials, we discussed fixed update method and update method. In this video tutorial, we focus on late update event method. We know that fixed update event method is called after every predefined fixed time step. That is, fixed update method is called after every 0.02 seconds. Whereas update method is called once per frame. Late update method is called once after every update method called. After every update method called, once late update method is called, guys. That is the reason its name is late update. We know that fixed update event method is called after every 0.02 seconds. Fixed update is independent of game's frame refresh rate. Whether game is running at 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second or 100 frames per second does not matter. It always called after every 0.02 seconds. Whereas update method is called once per frame. Update method depends upon game's frame refresh rate. If game is running at 30 frames per second, then update method is called 30 times per second. If game is running at 60 frames per second, then update method is called 60 times per second. If game is running at 100 frames per second, then update method is called 100 times per second. Late update method is called once after every update method call. After every update method call, late update method is called, guys. That means if the game is running at 30 frames per second, update method is called 30 times per second. Late update method is also called 30 times per second because late update method is called once after every update method call. If game is running at 60 frames per second, we know that update method is called 60 times per second. Late update method is also called 60 times per second because after every update, late update method is called, guys. Let me show that. I go to Unity. Here below the update method, I am going to add late update method. I say void late late update, opening flower bracket, closing flower bracket. I say here debug.log in double quotations. I say late update. I save this code. I say file save. When I run this code, what happens, guys? First awake is displayed. Then on enable is displayed, then is application pause false is displayed, then is application has focus true is displayed, then start is displayed. After every 0.02 seconds, fixed update is displayed. Based on the game's frame refresh rate, update and late update are displayed. Let me go to Unity. I click on the play button. Once I click on the play button, you will see here awake displayed once, on enable displayed once, is application pause false displayed once, is application has focus true displayed once, start displayed once. You can see fixed update is called continuously, so we are seeing fixed update displayed here. You can see that it is continuously called and executed. You can see update and late update are called continuously. I stop here. If you carefully observe, update method is called 1619 times. Late update method is also called 1619 times. That means after every update method call, late update is called, guys. I expand the code so that I can show you clearly here. You can see update, late update. We have fixed update here. update, late update. We have fixed update here. Update, late update. After every update, late update method is getting called. Let me collapse again back. I hope you guys are clearly understanding. Let me explain more. We know that fixed update method is best for physics based updates. Update method is best for any non-physics based updates. Late update method is best for keeping track of current game objects or other game objects update, guys. In the late update method, you are going to keep track of other game objects update. Let's take an example here. If you want to move the camera with respect to player movement, then first player should be moved, then the camera, right? So player movement code must be written in the update method and the camera movement code must be written in the late update method, because first update method is called, so player will be moving, then the late update method will be called, the camera will be following the player. That's it, guys. I hope you guys have clearly understood. I think for this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. I suggest you people to watch this video again and again, understand everything clearly. In the upcoming video tutorials, we get more information. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial. The best.